Hey everyone, I'm Ryan from ratings.com, and today we'll be taking a look at Samsung's lineup of TVs for 2019. We've bought and tested all of them, so in this video, we'll see how they compare. They are mostly 4K HDR TVs, but at the end of this video, we'll take a look at Samsung's push into the 8K resolution territory. Something important to note is Samsung often has slightly different model numbers for the same TVs in different markets, and sometimes even within the same region, to avoid price matching between retailers. You can check the description below for a list of models we expect to be equivalent. Samsung generally offers a wide selection of nicely designed TVs at many different price points. They have a signature look and are generally pretty versatile sets. They also have great low input lag and smart features, and some models have improved the previously bad viewing angles with new technology added to the displays. That being said, not all of this year's models receive the same kind of preferential treatment, so we'll take a closer look at how each model performed. You can find the full comprehensive review and measurements for each of these TVs on our website, and the links for each model will be in the description below. Let's start with the most affordable TV and work our way up through the product line. The RU7100 is the entry-level model Samsung released in 2019. It has decent picture quality thanks to its VA-type panel that has a good contrast ratio at the expense of viewing angles. It supports HDR formats HDR10 and 10+, but overall the HDR experience is lackluster because the RU7100 doesn't have a wide color gamut or good peak brightness. Other omissions from this budget-friendly television are a local dimming backlight to improve darkroom performance and any VRR support. Luckily, the TV still has excellent low input lag, so gamers can breathe a sigh of relief there. And the same is true for the RU7300. The RU7300 is the curved version of the RU7100, so the only real difference between the two is the design. The two perform almost identically and include the same basic remote in the box, the same ports, and nearly identical speaker performance. The rest of the TVs I'll cover, starting with the RU8000, come with a better remote that is very responsive and doesn't require line of sight. The first real step up in the 2019 lineup is the RU8000. It has a 120Hz display, VRR support, and a wide color gamut. The curious and in fact disappointing thing about this TV is that it's a slight step backwards compared to last year's NU8000. The RU8000 went away from the bezel-less sleek design of the NU8000 in favor of a more plasticky, wider bezel look. The RU8000 got rid of the local dimming the NU8000 had, which has had an impact on the peak brightness levels, which are significantly dimmer on the RU8000. Besides these mild downgrades, the rest of the TV performs very similarly to the NU8000 and, on a more positive note, the RU8000 supports more resolutions and seems to have had a bump in the speed of the smart menu. The NU8000 will still be a better buy if you can still find one, but otherwise the RU8000 will do a good job. Interestingly, if you're looking for a 32-inch 4K TV, the only way to go is the Q50R because it doesn't have any competition at the moment. It was released in the later part of 2019 and is a good 32-inch TV with a wide color gamut and good low input lag. Moving on to what is supposed to be the next step up, the Q60R. It is a quantum dot LED TV and is the successor to the Q6FN, but it falls short of its older brother. In fact, the Q60R is extremely similar to the RU8000 in many ways. It has dropped the local dimming the Q6FN had and has lower peak brightness, which is very similar to what we saw on the RU8000. Nonetheless, it's a good TV with low input lag, a wide color gamut, and good contrast levels. But if you can manage to get your hands on the older Q6FN, it is the better buy. Samsung also released a new version of the Frame TV this year, which got the upgrade to QLED, and we expect it to perform very similarly to the Q60R. It recently won on our suggestion tool, so we purchased it and will be reviewing it shortly. So far, the 2019 Samsung TVs we've looked at haven't been great improvements over last year's models, but things get better from here on out. The Samsung Q70R is a great TV. It is the least expensive full-array local dimming TV offered by Samsung this year and has a great picture quality. It has an excellent contrast ratio and black uniformity that are helped by the local dimming feature, so darkroom performance is great. The 8 Series QLED from 2019 is where things really start to heat up. The Q80R is an excellent TV and is one of the most impressive LED TVs we've ever tested. It has an amazing reflection handling that really cuts down on ambient light. It gets nice and bright, so HDR content pops and has great detail. It also has great viewing angles for a VA-type display. This is due to the optical layer technology called Ultra Viewing Angle Samsung has developed for a few of their highest-end models this year, the Q80, 85, 90, and 900R. Usually optical layer technologies can affect the contrast and raise black levels, but the local dimming implementation is great and offsets the black levels. Do note, the Q80R released in Europe is a more basic version of the Q80R in the US. The US QADR is more similar to the Q85 that was released this year for European markets. At the moment, we only test US models, so we haven't tested the Q85R, but we expect it to perform very similarly to the Q80R and the Q90R. Speaking of which, the Q90R is the highest-end 4K QLED TV Samsung has released in 2019. It is an amazing TV with excellent picture quality. It's kind of like a beefed-up Q80R with all the dials turned up to 11. It has Samsung's One Connect, so all the ports and power supply are in a separate unit you can hide away. It has a great local dimming feature that, thanks to its large number of dimmable zones, allows the TV to attain an excellent contrast ratio, as well as minimize blooming and achieve a high peak brightness. Coupled with the wide color gamut and great color volume, this TV is sure to deliver an impactful and impressive picture. If price isn't a concern, this is the best 4K Samsung TV from 2019. In many aspects, it does perform similarly to the Q80R though, so the Q80R probably offers better value for money for most people. Late last year, Samsung made the push into the 8K resolution market. This year, they released the Q900RB that is advertised to support HDMI 2.1 and is able to accept 8K signals. For those of you in Europe, the Q900RB is named the Q950R. The Q900 is an excellent 8K TV. Picture quality is impressive on this set, so it's great if you're interested in making the push into 8K. We're not sure if the jump to 8K is worth it just yet, as there is an exhaustive lack of 8K content available for consumers. We don't evaluate the performance of 8K upscaling yet, so for now, unless money is not a factor and you just want the maximum resolution, a 4K set will be better for most people. So that's Samsung's lineup of 2019 TVs. There were some great sets that impressed us this year, and some others that were questionable upgrades over last year's models. Let us know in the comments section which one you're gonna go with. As I said at the beginning of the video, if you wanna check out how a specific model performed more in depth, check out the reviews on our website. You can also become an insider on the website if you wanna have access to our latest test results before we publish them. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel for more and let us know what you'd like to see next. Now, last thing, I promise. We're currently hiring at our offices in Montreal for various positions. So, if you're looking to help people find the best product for their needs, have a look at the career page on our website for more info. Thank you very much for watching and see you next time.